Are you ready for .NET MAUI? Because I am. I have MAUI shirt, and also I have MAUI mug. I don't know how they do it, but the coffee tastes better from this mug. Cheers. All right, so let me introduce myself. I'm honored to be Microsoft MVP. I'm also a leader of Xamarin Warsaw Mobile Developers, and I'm also administrator of group for Polish developers on Facebook. In my spare time, I'm blogging and tweeting, obviously about Xamarin. But you are not here to learn about me, but you are here to learn about .NET MAUI. But before we jump to .NET MAUI, I would like to take all of you on a trip down a memory lane. So I would like to talk a little bit about history of Xamarin Forms. So actually, the first version of Xamarin Forms was released in 2014. It was over 7 years ago. At that time, I was working as Windows Phone developer. I think this is still a great platform. So the next version was released in 2015, and in that year, it was my first experience with Xamarin. I was working on Xamarin native application. And the year later, in 2016, Microsoft acquires Xamarin. Maybe some of you remember these days, because before that, Xamarin was a paid solution. So you had to pay to use Xamarin. When Microsoft acquires Xamarin, Xamarin becomes free for everyone. So moving forward, the version 3 was released in 2018, version 4 2019, and the latest and the last version of Xamarin Forms was released this year in May. And during this period of time, many services were launched to help us create mobile applications. None of these services are longer existing. Some of these services were closed and others were incorporated into other services. Like, for example, Xamarin Test Cloud is now part of App Center. And I remember like it was yesterday when I was doing my certification at Xamarin University. Okay. Bogdan is asking where you get that cap. I get it at Bonfire. Gerard was tweeting about it some time ago. I will put a link later. just remember me at the end of the presentation. Okay, so moving forward. So .NET MAUI. So .NET MAUI stands for .NET Multi-Platform App UI. .NET MAUI is successor to Xamarin Forms, and .NET MAUI will allow you to create native applications for mobile and desktop with shared code. .NET MAUI is currently in preview 10, which is based on .NET 6. And with .NET MAUI, you will be able to create applications for iOS, Android, macOS with support of Mac Catalyst. You will be able also to create applications for Windows with support of WinUI 3. And what's interesting, Samsung will provide support for its system Tizen. And also one interesting thing is that with .NET MAUI, you will be able to create application for Linux. However, this platform will be supported by community. Moving forward, what is the roadmap of .NET MAUI? As I mentioned, currently we have preview 10 of .NET MAUI. Another preview, which is preview 11, is planned for this month. And release candidate is planned for Q1 next year. And GA version is planned for Q2 also next year. I'm crossing my fingers for that date. So you may start wonder how long will Xamarin Forms be supported after the release of .NET MAUI. Sorry, I will let another participant in. Okay, he should join now. So when .NET MAUI will launch, we will have 1 year to migrate our Xamarin Forms application to .NET MAUI. So I guess this is a pretty long period of time to be able to migrate our applications. And as I mentioned, the last version of Xamarin Forms is version 5. However, during this 1 year period, Xamarin Forms will still receive service updates with bug fixes. Okay, moving on. So if you would like to play with .NET MAUI now, how to do it? So let's start with Windows. The best way to configure .NET MAUI on Windows is to use preview version of Visual Studio 2022. And you need to remember to select mobile development workload during installation. And that's it. Visual Studio should install everything for you so you can have .NET MAUI on your local machine. And how about macOS? This is also the same story. Use a preview version of Visual Studio 2022, and it should install everything for you. However, on my macOS, I didn't succeed to configure MAUI. MAUI on my macOS is still not compiling. Maybe you will have a better luck. And how about Visual Studio code? Microsoft doesn't have any plans for now to officially support this IDE, and support for it is described as experimental. So I guess you are using it at your own risk. What's worth to mention is a console tool, MAUI check. However, this tool is now obsolete. So why do I mention it? Because if you start learning about .NET MAUI, probably you will encounter this tool. This tool was used a few months before preview version of the latest Visual Studio. And the goal of this tool was to install all the required things on your local machine in order to run .NET MAUI. However, as I mentioned, this tool is now obsolete, so just use a preview version of Visual Studio to install .NET MAUI on your local machine. All right, so what's new and exciting about .NET MAUI? So first of all, there will be single project. But before we jump into that, let's see how the project structure is looking right now in Xamarin Forms. So if you create Xamarin Forms application in your solution, you will have separate projects for Android, iOS, and probably for Windows. We will also have shared project with your XAML views and a shared code. .NET MAUI is changing this, and in your solution, there will be only one project. And in that project, there will be platform-specific folders. There will be folder for Android, iOS, Mac, and Windows. And thanks to single project, it will be easier to share images, font, app icons, splash screen nuggets, and platform-specific code. What's also new in .NET MAUI is bootstrapping your application. .NET MAUI will use .NET generic host known from ASP.NET Core, so it will provide builder for your application. With builder, you can bootstrap your application. So you can, for example, configure fonts, configure lifecycle events. You can also use built-in IOC container. And with preprocessor directives, you can inject different implementation for specific platforms. What's also new in .NET MAUI is new handler architecture. But before we jump into that, let's refresh our minds how to access platform-specific code in Xamarin Forms. So if you would like to change some UI component and use platform-specific code, you need to use custom renderers. But there are no custom renderers in .NET MAUI. You are using handlers. And why .NET MAUI is not using custom renderers, but .NET MAUI is introducing new handler architecture. First of all, handlers architecture has better performance because in your Xamarin Forms application, when your application is starting, it's doing assembly scanning in order to find any custom renderers in any assembly. So there is no such thing in .NET MAUI. So .NET MAUI applications will launch faster. About this new handler architecture. So each UI component receives an abstraction layer in the form of interface. So in this example, we have a button component and it has interface I button. This interface is used by handlers. So for example, on iOS, button handler will use native UI button component to render button on the screen. On Android, button handler will use app compat button to render button on Android. And new handler architecture is very flexible. So for example, you can create your own handler for UI component. And probably maybe you would like to draw the controls on canvas and not using the native components. And you may start wondering how to actually access platform specific code in new handlers architecture. So here is a very basic example, how to access platform specific code for entry component. So in this example, we are appending mapping to the background property of our entry. And with preprocessor directives, we are accessing platform specific code using native view property. And we are setting background to red on every platform. So it's very basic example. And let's compare this example to Xamarin Forms. So if you would like to access background in Xamarin Forms on entry, you will have to create custom renderers for every platform. So new handlers architecture is making easier to access platform-specific code. Moving on. And because of new handlers architecture, every UI component in .NET MAUI needs to be rewritten to use this new architecture. So what can you right now use from .NET MAUI? So let's start from the pages. You can use content page, flyout page, navigation page, tapped page. And from layouts, you can use, for example, absolute layout or actually, maybe not, because we are talking just before that nobody uses absolute layout. But for sure, you can use a grid, stack layout, and scroll view. And from the views, right now, for example, you can use a checkbox, a date picker, progress bar, or a slider. On the other hand, there are still some UI components that MAUI team is working on to bring them to .NET MAUI. And for example, collection view, entry, label, picker, radio button are still under construction. .NET MAUI team is still working to implement those UI components for .NET MAUI. And the next great thing about .NET MAUI is that it will support .NET Hot Reload. So in this basic example, I am editing string in my code behind, clicking on the button, and on my running application without recompiling, this string is being updated on the screen. This is very convenient and it's speeding up application development. Okay, moving on. So demo, let's jump to the Visual Studio and let's see MAUI in action. So here I have a preview version of the latest Visual Studio. As I mentioned, there is only one project in our solution. And platform specific code is here in platforms folder. We have separate folder for Android, with main activity, with Android manifest. We have separate folder for iOS, with info police file and with app delegate. And of course, we have a folder for macOS and for Windows. And also, as I mentioned, we have new way to bootstrap our MAUI application. Sorry. So here we are creating a builder of our application. We are telling builder to use MAUI app, and here we are providing type of our app class. We will jump to app class in a moment. And we are also configuring the fonts. And at the end, we are invoking build method. And that's it. Our MAUI application will be bootstrapped. So let's go to the app class. Maybe let's start with code behind. Or maybe not, because this is the sample I would like to show you later. So let's jump to the XAML. So in XAML of our app class, we have a main page, and main page of our application is shell. And we are using shell to create three tabs. Station list with list of elements and tab for handlers and tab for code sharing. So now maybe let's jump into our application and see how it looks like. I have prepared a version for Windows and version for Android. However, compiling iOS is not still working on my local Windows machine. So on the left is Windows, on the right is Android, and you might start wonder what is this list of strings. So this list of strings is the list of the stations, and what stations? So during this time of the year, the air quality in Poland becomes a serious topic, and our application will fetch data from Chief Inspectorate of Environmental Protection. So here I am at the web page of Chief Inspectorate. Let's refresh the page and let's see how air quality in Poland it is right now. So currently I am in Warsaw. So let's check the air quality. Oh, it's still wanting. Okay, so the air quality in Warsaw is good. So that's good. However, the air quality at the south of the Poland is really bad. Yeah. Okay, so let's go back to our application. So as I mentioned, I'm in Warsaw, so I will check some station from Warsaw. Let's choose Warszawa, Aleja Niepodległości. Let's do it on Windows, and also let's do it on Android. Okay, almost there. Okay. So it's a very basic example, and the application is telling that the air quality in this station in Warsaw is good. All right, so maybe let's now check how this page is created from technical perspective. So let's check the XAML for stations page. And here in stations page, I'm actually using a stack layout with bindable layout items source. And the reason that I'm using this is because collection view is still not implemented in .NET MAUI. So I have my item template with just one label and with tab gesture recognizer. So after tapping the element on the list, the details of specific station will be loaded. So let's see how the view model of our station's page looks like. So in the view model, I have used Refit to fetch data from REST API of Chief Inspectorate. We have one method load station, which is invoking REST API, and it's assigning a list of stations to the station's property. Very simple, very standard way of doing MVVM. And let's check out a code behind for stations page. And it's also very pretty simple. In onAppearing method, we are invoking load stations commands, which will load our stations. And after tapping on the element on the list, the details of specific stations will load. All right, so maybe let's tweak a little bit our UI, because probably you will agree with me, it could be better. So I will jump into XAML for our details of the station, and we will tweak a little bit this UI. So first of all, let's make this label bigger. So I will set font size to 60, hit control saved, and it's immediately updated. And maybe let's make this label to the center of the screen. So let's set vertical and horizontal alignment. So, okay, I hit save. Oh, actually it didn't work. Interesting. It was working before the presentation. Okay, it happens all the time. So anyway, what I wanted you to show is that XAML hot reload is still working in .NET MAUI. Okay, so Łukasz is telling that it does not work for desktop. So actually before presentation, it was working. it happens all the time. All right, the other thing I want you to show is .NET hot reload. As I mentioned before, .NET MAUI will support .NET hot reload. So what I would like to do is to open station details view model. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to write return statement here. So the details of the station won't load. So I have written return statement, hit save. And now if I go to the details of the station, nothing should happen. Yes, and nothing is happening. The details of the stations are not loading, no matter which element I choose. So now let me comment this return statement, hit save, and now the details should work again. Yeah, and they are working. So .NET hot reload is working in .NET MAUI, and I think this is a great feature to speed our development. So moving forward, I would like to show you how the handlers are working. So let's jump to our app XAML CS. And here we have a very basic example of appending mapping of a checkbox component. So for Windows, we are setting checkbox background to pink, and on Android, we are setting backgrounds to red. So let me open the Android, open the handlers page, and yes, as you can see, the background for checkbox is red on Android and it's pink on Windows. So very basic example, just to show how to access platform specific code using new handlers architecture. And the last thing from the demo I would like to show you is code sharing. So I will switch to the third tab and open my solution explorer. So what's worth to mention is that everything you put inside platform specific folders will compile only for this platform. Okay, so I will let another person in. Okay, should be good now. Here I have a very basic example just to show you code sharing strategy. I have a message service, which is a public static partial class, and it has a public static partial method, which will return string. And on Android, our class will return a string hello from Android. And on the Windows, our class will return a string hello from Windows. And to show you how this will be handled, let me open the code behind for this page. So if user click on the button, I will get message from message service and use display errors to show this message to the user. So let's see it in action. If I click on the button on Windows, it's telling me hello from Windows. If I click on the button on Android, it's telling me hello from Android. So this is one of the way to share code across different platforms. So remember, everything you put inside platform-specific folders will be compiled only on this specific platform. Okay, and let's go back to the slides. So the demo I just show you is available at my GitHub if you are interested. And moving on, Blazor. .NET MAUI will allow you to host Blazor application. And in order to do that, you will need to use a Blazor WebView component and invoke two methods in your builder. So you will need to invoke method register Blazor MAUI WebView and add Blazor WebView. And as you can see in the example at the bottom of the screen, hosting Blazor application inside .NET MAUI is working. However, keep in mind that this is a very, very basic example. And hosting Blazor application inside .NET MAUI is described still as experimental. Okay, moving on. Another interesting thing worth to mention is Microsoft MAUI graphics. And what is this? Microsoft MAUI graphics is a cross-platform graphics library. However, it is described as experimental and doesn't have official support by Microsoft. And this library offers you several APIs to draw on canvas. So you can draw rectangles, path images, fonts, and so on. You can even create PDFs. And there are several supported platforms by this library, which is iOS, Android, macOS, WPF, UWP, WinForms, Citizen, and Linux. And what's more, there is another library, Microsoft MAUI Graphics Controls, built on top of the previous one. And this library is providing cross-platform drawn controls. So the controls that are drawn on the screen using Canvas and are not using the native components. And like before, this library is also still in experimental state. Microsoft MAUI Graphics Controls has three built-in themes, Cupertino, Fluent, and Material, has dark mode support, and it's described as high performance. So you don't need to worry that drawn controls will have worse performance than the native components. And here is the example how drone controls are looking and working. So I think it's looking pretty good. So from available controls, you can choose from button checkbox, date picker, editor, enter, and so on. There are many controls that you can use to create your UIs. And if you would like to use this library in your MAUI application, you need to register its handlers. So you can choose, for example, that for button, you want to have a handler that will draw button instead using, for example, app compact or UI button. Okay, and few words about third-party support. So there are right now three companies that support .NET MAUI by providing UI components for it. So the first company is DevExpress. And DevExpress is providing its UI components in the preview version, and everything you see on the screen is actually drawn. DevExpress is using mentioned library Microsoft MAUI graphics. So everything you see, it's drawn. There is no native components used. Another company is SyncFusion. SyncFusion also offers MAUI components in the preview state. And SyncFusion is also using Microsoft MAUI graphics to draw its controls on the screen. And the last company is Telerik, and here is the same story. Telerik also have the preview version of controls for .NET MAUI, and Telerik is also using Microsoft MAUI graphic to draw controls on the screen. And now let's talk a little bit about architecture. So in .NET MAUI, as you saw on the demo, you can still use MVVM pattern. So the pattern you already know and like. But maybe let's talk a little bit about it to refresh our memory. So MVVM, which is model view view model. View model is providing data to be displayed. View is displaying this data to the user. View model is manipulating the model, which is, for example, accessing REST API or accessing a local database. And view model is using INotify prepared to change interface to notify view that something new has been prepared, and view is updating its visual state. And there has been created many MVVM frameworks to help creating applications with this pattern. And in my personal opinion, it's worth to mention these three, which are MVVM Cross, Reactive UI, and Prism. And I'm pretty sure these frameworks will support .NET MAUI. What's new in .NET MAUI is MVU pattern, which is Model View Update. So long story short, model is providing a current application state to the view. View is rendering its visual present based on a provided state. And view is also dispatching messages, so new updated model is being created. And if you would like to play with this pattern, you can use the Comet library, which is not using any XAML to create its view. You are using pure C# to create your UI components. So this library is following Flutter style. So in this very basic example, we have a vertical stack, which contains two UI components, text and the button. After clicking on a button, our variable click count is being incremented, and click count variable is of type of state, which is a special type to notify view that something has been updated. In the next example, it's also very simple. We have also a vertical stack with more UI components, text field, secure field, slider, progress bar. And we also have two variables, text value, slider value of type state. What you need to keep in mind that Comet library is still in experimental state. Okay, and now let's talk a little bit about migrating our Xamarin Forms application to .NET MAUI. So let's answer the first question you may ask. So what XAML will be supported by .NET MAUI? And as you already saw on the demo, .NET MAUI will support exactly the same XAML as Xamarin Forms. So everything you already know and like, you will be able to reuse it in .NET MAUI. Second question you may ask is that will it be possible to use existing Nugget packages in .NET MAUI? And of course, yes, if Nugget packages will have dependency on .NET 6 and reference the new namespaces. And what about Xamarin Community Toolkit? You will need to use specific version of this toolkit for .NET MAUI, which is Community Toolkit MAUI. And how about Xamarin Essentials? So in this case, Xamarin Essentials are being built into .NET MAUI. So all you need to do is use a new namespace, Microsoft MAUI Essentials, and that's it. You can use Essentials in your application. Very convenient. Okay, let's move on. .NET Upgrade Assistant. What it is? It is a console tool that will upgrade your existing Forms application to .NET MAUI. Currently, this tool is providing preview support for migrating Forms application to .NET MAUI. And using .NET Upgrade Assistance will be the best way to migrate your Xamarin Forms application into .NET MAUI. However, I guess migration process will depend on the specific application. I think that a smaller application will be easier to migrate, and the bigger application will require more work. But when starting migration, you should start with .NET Upgrade Assistant and see if this tool will migrate everything for you. Probably there will be some things that you will still need to do by hand. And what will change? Obviously, the namespaces will change. So for example, there will be no Xamarin Forms namespace, and you will be using Microsoft MAUI or Microsoft MAUI Controls namespace. Okay, the next question, will it be possible to reuse our behaviors and converters? And yes, we will be able to reuse behaviors and converters, and everything that needs to be done is to update namespaces. Okay, and what about custom renderers? Because as I mentioned, there are no custom renderers in .NET MAUI because there is new handlers architecture. So do we need to rewrite custom renderers to new handlers architecture? Actually, no, because there will be support to reuse our custom renderers, and we will need to invoke method apt compatibility renderer in our application builder. So I think this is very convenient. Okay, and what about effects? Can I reuse effects in .NET MAUI application? And the answer is yes. You will need to move your code from platform projects into one code file and use preprocessor directives. And also you will need to invoke a special method in application builder. And moving to the end of the presentation, you might start to wonder, what should I choose for my new project? Should I choose still Xamarin Forms, or maybe should I choose .NET MAUI? And the answer is, it depends. It depends on the project you are going to create. You should think about what requirements your project has. If these requirements are filled in by .NET MAUI, probably you should consider using .NET MAUI. However, in my personal opinion, if I would like to start a new project currently, I will still go with Xamarin Forms, because at least in my opinion, I think Xamarin Forms right now is a more mature framework. But as I mentioned, it really depends on the project you are going to create. And that's pretty much it, what I had prepared for you today. Here is the link to the slides and quick survey. I will appreciate filling the survey. And do you have any questions?
Hi, Damian.
Hello.
Łukasz Szumel from the site. I have a question about custom handlers. I will try to give some quick overview. I noticed that many companies still try to invest into Xamarin Native. And personally, I think that most of these things can be done with Xamarin Forms with embedded native controls. Do we have such possibility in MAUI?
Okay, you mean embedding native controls in .NET MAUI? Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think there should be this possibility. However, I didn't found yet any information about it. But if it was supported in Xamarin Forms, I think it should be also supported in .NET MAUI.
Okay, thanks. Okay, so maybe another question, because I see that there's no one interested. Okay, so we live with the XAM for many, many years, and when Microsoft announced that MAUI will support Blazor, I think that most of us, I mean Xamarin developers, thought, okay, maybe we will be able to reuse existing XAM to run the application in the browser. Currently on the market, we have, for example, Uno platform, which do such thing. And we have also another framework. I don't remember the name. It was based on WPF dialect. How it will be with MAUI in future?
Okay, so the question is, as I understand, if we will be able to run MAUI applications on the web, yes?
Yes, because currently yeah. we have this Blazor with mobile yeah. bindings, yeah. Mm-hmm. So it is completely different approach because you use those MAUI controls, XAM controls inside Razor pages. And I thought that, for example, Microsoft allow us to just run those pages which we already have on the web, like we do currently with mobile platforms.
Yeah, I understand the question. This is a very good question you ask. However, I didn't found any information about this when I was preparing this presentation, but I will write this down and should look for some answers.
Okay, thanks.
Okay, guys, are there any questions? Okay, I don't hear any questions, so I guess I will stop sharing my screen. So if there will be any questions later that you would like to ask, just reach me out in social media. I will be happy to answer any questions if I know the answer, obviously. And I guess that pretty much it for today. I would like to thank you, all of you, to joining us today. I hope these presentations were useful for you, and I hope you learned some new things today, and you had a pretty good time. And Bogdan, I will also like to thank you once again for joining our meetup and giving a great presentations about modern UI. And so, guys, I hope we'll meet again in the future. I'm looking forward for this. And remember to stay safe in these strange times. So that's pretty much it. So thank you, everyone, and see you soon. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Thank you very much.